If we are accepting someone from outside at the cost of our basis, cultural basis, this is disaster. It's a simple way to make war, domestic war, and this is stupid.
Poland has taken a resolute stance in keeping unauthorized migrants away from its borders, implementing a series of measures that have brought its migrant crisis to nearly zero.
Immigrants, especially illegal immigrant, is not welcome in Poland. This is what we promised, and these words will be kept. Basically, we are not talking about people who are in need. We are not talking about Muslims. We are talking about a law, international law and Polish law. We don't want any illegal migration in Poland. This is what we promised. This is why our government was elected, and not even one Muslim illegal migrant will come to Poland ever.
Unlike many other European nations that welcomed hundreds of thousands of refugees fleeing war and conflict, Poland has maintained firm control over its immigration policies.
Our parliament passed the law that we can use live bullets now. So if you want to come to Poland, you will be killed. If you don't want to be killed, do not come to Polish border. If you don't want to be pushed back, do not come to Polish border.
In today's video, we'll explore the comprehensive strategies Poland employs to tackle its migrant crisis and examine the implications of these policies. So, if you haven't already, subscribe to our channel and ring the bell icon for upcoming updates. Now, pay close attention.
The problem started in 2015 when migration started from Muslim countries. That's why they called me Islamophobe. It has nothing to do with Islamophobia. This is just a fact. That from 2015, millions, not hundreds of thousands, millions coming to Europe were coming from Muslim countries. So that was a flood, a wave of Muslim illegal migrants. And we knew and we know that this is a hybrid war, organized by Putin through Belarus. So if someone is asking me how is it possible, it's very simple. We built the wall. That's number one. Mr. Trump was inspiration.
Poland's government has long prided itself on its strong opposition to uncontrolled migration. Polish politicians, including MP Dominik Tarczyński from the ruling Law and Justice Party, have defended these policies, arguing that they are necessary for maintaining national safety. They have even passed a law to border security to shoot any illegal migrant trying to smuggle into the country. This law came into effect after one of the Polish security guards was killed with a spear by an illegal migrant. Tarczyński has emphasized that Poland's approach is based on legal distinctions between refugees and illegal immigrants, insisting that the government's primary responsibility is to protect its citizens rather than sympathizing with people coming from questionable cultural backgrounds. While countries like Germany and France have accepted large numbers of refugees from Syria, Afghanistan, and Eritrea, Poland has opted for a more closed border approach. The government's philosophy centers around national safety and security, which has driven its decision to resist taking in refugees. One of the most significant measures Poland has adopted is the strengthening of its border security. This includes deploying additional military and police forces to the borders, particularly in areas where illegal crossings are most likely to occur. Poland has invested in advanced surveillance technology, including drones and cameras, to monitor its borders effectively. Secondly, Poland has enacted stringent immigration laws that make it nearly impossible for unauthorized migrants to enter the country. These laws include severe penalties for human traffickers and strict guidelines for asylum applications. The government has made it clear that illegal immigration is not tolerated, and individuals attempting to cross the border without proper documentation face immediate deportation. Also, the Polish government has clarified that it will only accept refugees who meet specific criteria under international law. This distinction between refugees and economic migrants is critical. Poland has emphasized that those who do not flee from the first safe country are considered illegal migrants and are not welcome. While Poland has closed its doors to many migrants, it has welcomed over 2 million Ukrainian nationals, primarily due to the ongoing conflict in Ukraine. This influx has been framed as a humanitarian response, and the Polish government has provided support for these migrants who share common cultural and historical ties with Poland. The government has actively engaged in public awareness campaigns to inform citizens about the potential risks of uncontrolled migration. By highlighting security concerns and the challenges faced by other European nations, Poland aims to garner public support for its strict immigration policies. Despite its tough stance on illegal migration, Poland faces a significant labor shortage, which has led to an influx of migrant workers from neighboring countries. The government recognizes the need for foreign labor to fill gaps in various industries. However, the approach remains selective, focusing primarily on migrants from countries with cultural similarities, such as Ukraine. Poland's strong stance on migration reflects a broader trend of prioritizing national security over humanitarian concerns. By implementing a series of stringent measures, the government aims to keep illegal migrants away while selectively allowing in those who meet specific criteria. While this approach addresses immediate security concerns, it also raises questions about the long-term implications for Poland's economy and its relationship with the European Union. What are your thoughts on Poland's approach to migration? Do you think it is a sustainable strategy? Share your opinions in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe for more updates on global migration issues. Thank you for watching.